Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean the Fog Crawler. We're coming to you today from El Dorado County here in the High Sierra. Today we're going to be making pigs in a cornfield. It's an old recipe that Arkansas redneck inspired me to give it a try. Stay tuned. Today's recipe, the ingredients include some pork. We're using pork steak, we're using some mild pork sausage, and we're using some spicy habanero pork sausage. We've got cobbettes of corn, we're using potatoes, onions, garlic, we're using some red pepper and some habanero seasoning, pepper medley, we've got some chipotle rub. We're using a can of creamy poblano and queso cheese soup, and we're using two cans of cream of mushroom soup, some sliced jalapenos. This should be good. Okay, we take our oiled oven, we spread out a can of cream of mushroom soup, we take the cobbettes, and we place them evenly spaced around the perimeter. Should take, I'm thinking about 8 or 9 of these little cobbettes.
This is a 12-inch oven.
Yes. Oh. I think I can squeeze a 9th one in there. Okay, we're going to dump our potatoes in. I'm going to spread these out. Make sure we get these in between the corn so the corns don't slide together and touch. Got our onions. Now we're going to throw some spicy sausage.
And this sausage is uncooked at this time.
Yes.
Okay.
Everything is uncooked.
Is that going to be enough, or should we do the big one? No, I left over some. Or should we do the big one?
Okay, now we're going to add our garlic. Spread that around a bit. Got some sliced jalapenos. Definitely better spread those out a little bit. We've got some habanero seasoning. We've got some cayenne red pepper seasoning. Okay, I've added the mild sausage. Now I'm going to put some chipotle seasoning in. Now we're going to add the cheesy soup.
This is Campbell's brand.
I've spread the creamy cheese soup around. Now I'm going to add the pork steak. I'm going to add a little bit of chipotle seasoning onto the pork steak. And then we're going to take the second can cream of mushroom soup and spread that around on top. We're going to cook this for approximately 2 hours. Be using 8 briquettes on the bottom and 16 briquettes on the top.
For temperature of?
around 350. This is an easy recipe, and it should be very tasty.
Right now he's putting on a peppercorn medley.
I've got 8 briquettes underneath the oven, and I've got 16 briquettes on top of the lid. We're going to do one cold change after 1 hour. We'll probably flip the pork steak at that time, and then we'll do one more hour of a fresh batch of briquettes. 16 on top, 8 on bottom. It's been on for an hour. We're going to do our cold change now. But first, we're going to flip the pork steaks. Definitely.
So after he's done flipping them, he's going to go ahead and do a cold change, put it back on, and cook it for approximately another hour.
Okay, the pigs in the cornfield has been on for 2 hours. Let's take a look and see what it's... Ooh, that looks good. I think we'll just break that meat apart and serve it up.
Looks wonderful. And this, folks, is what pigs in a cornfield looks like plated up. We have the corn, potatoes, pork, and those habaneros. Looks delicious. Oh, fog crawler's finger looking good, huh?
Needs to cool down a little bit. But it's definitely tasty. Very tasty. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's webisode. I'm Dean the Fog Crawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
Thanks for watching today's webisode. I'm Joni. Till the next time, happy trails to you.
One thing, let the corn cool down before you bite into it.